Good evening.
Good evening.
We're so glad you've joined us. It's been a cold couple of days, but it's warm to be among believers and able to praise the Lord. Sorry, it's a bit chilly in here. But anyway, we'll warm right up by standing up and worshiping God. So let's stand up.
Our psalm tonight is part of Psalm 119, but it is not in your, this part's not in your hymn book, so I'm going to read it to you. Psalm 119, this is the longest chapter in the Bible. This is verses 97 through 104. So the psalmist says, "Oh, how I love your law. It is my meditation all day long. Your commandment makes me wiser than my enemies, for it's always with me. I have more understanding than all my teachers, for your decrees are my meditation. I understand more than the ages, for I keep your precepts. I hold back my feet from every evil way in order to keep your word. I do not turn away from your ordinances, for you have taught me. How sweet are your words to my taste, sweeter than honey to my mouth. Through your precepts, I get understanding. Therefore, I hate every false way. Remember, we looked at Jeremiah 31 Sunday, talking about having the law of God written on our hearts. And that is what the psalmist, this is the psalm from this past Sunday, and that's what the psalmist is talking about, is, you know, we so many times look at having the law of God as binding us, but in truth, it frees us. Paul talks about where there is no law, there's no liberty. We have to have laws and structures, but the one thing that the psalmist teaches us here is the wonderful story of the law of love and the joy that comes to us from keeping the law of God. It's not something we have to do. It's something we want to do. And see, that is, I think, one of the struggles that some parts of Christendom have, is they're like, okay, we have to do these things. Well, God is not making us do it. God wants us to want to serve Him. And that's why it's about having the law written on our heart. When we want to serve our Lord, keeping the law of love, the law of our Lord, is not hard because we want to. You know, I fuss at my son sometimes that he drives too fast. Anybody else have a child that does that? Maybe you or somebody, I'm not going to. I have never in my life gotten a speeding ticket. Now, I won't say that I shouldn't have gotten one, but I just have never gotten one. My son got one a few weeks ago. I was pretty upset. And he's learned a lesson because he had to pay for it. He's having to go to traffic school. And I said, Nathan, we have laws, traffic laws, for a reason. They're not there to hinder us. They're here to help us each other stay safe. And we keep our laws and our land to care for each other, to do what we need to do in our world. And that's part of the law of God, is that our Lord wants us to have that law written on our heart, wants us to live the law of love, the law of freedom. And it's freedom. That's what it is. It's freedom. Being a Christian frees us from sin. Sin is the bondage. Sin is what keeps us in prison. Sin's what destroys our world. Sin is what destroys our relationships with God and with each other and with ourselves. God's grace, love, and law are freedom that frees us from that because Jesus forgave us of it. So that's what the psalmist is talking about. We have freedom. So let's truly experience that freedom as we go to the table of our Lord. As always, all are invited to the table of our Lord. If you would turn to page 12 within your hymn book and join with me in our service. Christ our Lord invites to His table all who love Him, who earnestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved You with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done Your will. We have broken Your law. We've rebelled against Your love. We have not loved our neighbors. We have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to You, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. And so with Your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise Your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of Your glory. O Hosanna in highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. For the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church and delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. The night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread. And after giving thanks, which he always did, he broke the bread. And he said, take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. As often as you eat of this, do it in remembrance of me. When the supper was over, he took the cup. And once again, after giving thanks, which he always did, he gave it to his disciples and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which was poured out for you and for many and for the forgiveness of sins. Do this, and as often as you drink it, do it in remembrance of me. So in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ and one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, and your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Now with the confidence of the children of God, let us pray the prayer that our Lord taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And I invite those who are going to assist me to come forward, and I will serve you. Body of Christ broken for you. Eat this remembrance that Christ died for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. Drink this remembrance that Christ shed his blood for you. Please come. Thank you. Let us pray. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we go into the world renewed in your strength and your spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen.
Of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.